Hello, good morning, good evening, and welcome to Free Talk with Mr. B. We're on again for another episode of Suffered in Silence, Turn the Pain into Power. We're so excited to be on, and we have with us Maya and Hana. Hello, good evening, how are you guys? Great, great.
Good evening, good evening.
Yeah, we're good, great. Good evening, how are you, Mr. B?
I am doing well, and I look forward all week to having this second episode, because I know today we have a plan to talk about the MOP, and I think it's really interesting to tell our listeners, as they were eager to get more information from last week about what we were talking about. And today we're going to focus on your organization and why it's important to have that mindset that no child should suffer in silence, cry in darkness. Again, can we tell everyone again what is MOP?
Hi, yes. Well, good evening and good morning in the US, and good evening in the Philippines, and hello world, wherever you are. Have a good day. Yes, first of all, the first series that we haven't introduced ourselves properly. So my name is Marieta Monta, and people called me Maya or Mayette. So I am the founder and president of Maya's Organization Philippines. Maya's Organization Philippines is the raising awareness on child sexual abuse and helping rape victims in the Philippines. This is for, survivors, I myself a survivor, so I set up this Maya's Organization Philippines 5 years ago.
And it was so nice to be there with you guys during that 5-year celebration there in, I keep saying it wrong, Davao.
Yeah, thank you.
And very so much. It was such an honor to be there and an honor to connect with you two. And Hana was one of the members at that organization and at that meeting. And there were so many people there that was in your support and support for your organization. So I look forward to having them on as guests as we continue during the next few weeks. So today at your organization, yeah, we spoke about the mission and vision, and I saw it on your wall. I thought it was interesting, so I took a photo of it. But before going into that, the theme where no child should suffer in silence and cry in darkness is what I'd like you to highlight. I'm going to ask Hana about how to say this. She's going to teach me how to say walang bata ana. How do you say? tell me, how do you say
wala,
it?
Walang bata ang mag-suffer. walang bata ang mag-suffer in saya.
No, I'm terrible at Tagalog, so I'm going to say walang bata at anak na dapat magdusa sa kata
magdusan
at samikwa sa kadiliman. How did I do?
Okay, so, yeah, it's good. It's a good try. So no one should suffer in silence. Walang bata ang magdudusa sa katahimikan at manatiling
at sumigaw sa katahimikan.
That's we go sa kadiliman.
Yeah.
And I think it's important because it's the impetus of the whole thing. As an adult, and again, getting to 60 years old, I don't feel anyone, not even any child, anyone should suffer in silence. And so as we speak about this, the MOP organization, Maya's Organization Philippines, is as she become, and Maya, as you become, more and more empowered, you're hoping to eliminate a child, let's start with the Philippines, a child in the Philippines having to suffer in silence. Would that be correct?
Yes, correct.
And so that's why I didn't mind if you would tell your Tagalog listening audience what you really meant. So I think I probably really ruined that statement.
So either in Tagalog or Bisaya.
Okay, yeah.
So you can just use it sometimes if we really wanted to highlight what we really wanted to share to people.
Yeah. So this is the theme. No child should suffer in silence and right. cry in darkness. So it says, walang bata at anak na dapat magdusa sa katahimikan at sumigaw sa kadiliman.
Right, and so it's interesting about language, but it's very, very worldwide said, you know, because it's quite clear, no child around the world should suffer in silence. No one should suffer in silence. No child should be crying in darkness. And why I'm putting emphasis on it, because that's why we would come on to these podcasts and talk about this very subject, you know, because we want to make sure that it's clear. It's passionate for me. I raised my children and was very adamant about their safety, and they were just two boys. Imagine if I had two girls, how much more determined I would be. But either way, it was just really, really important to me to make sure that they're not suffering, much less in silence. And so I really appreciate your organization for that effort.
Thank you.
And so I wanted us to spend a minute just to tell your listeners about the mission and the vision. What do you think?
Yeah, sure.
This is where you come in this case, because I wanted not to blow that one. what do you want them to know? What is your goal? What is the organization's mission?
My book. Yes, this book called "Suffered in Silence: Turn the Pain into Power." So it says it means that. Yes, I'm talking by myself. Way back when I was a child, that I was suffering in silence because of my experience, my dark experience. It took my life in the dark for 33 years of my life. I was suffering, and I was, you know, my mouth was sealed. I wasn't able to tell anybody, even my family, what been happening to me when I was a child. So it was so hard to, you know, to cope with all those burden. And I wanted to say something to my friends, my family, my relatives, but I wasn't able to say something because I had a trauma, and my trauma, it took my life away at the time. So yeah, it wasn't easy to be a child and suffering in silence.
And to add up, like, the vision of Maya's organization, Philippines, is to empower communities that protect children against sexual abuse from Ate Mayet's experience. And the mission is to raise awareness on the prevention of the child sexual abuse and establish a shelter for holistic healing of sexually abused children. Because, you know, if a child suffered this, as what Ate Mayet experienced, she carried it for more than 30 years. So if MOP is here, now those people, those child experience, the same experience with Ate, would be able to somehow slowly express what they feel, and they could not suffer that long. So that is the mission of MOP.
And I appreciate that, because when Maya started speaking, she made a signal that our audio listeners wouldn't be able to tell. And it was a signal that zipped the mouth kind of signal. Mm-hmm. And we have that.
Exactly.
We have that among us in a lot of things that should not be. And I'll say it again, we have that among us where you have a zippered mouth against a lot of things that should not be. And the reason I say it is because we need not be in that level of silence. We need awareness. And yes. So the mm-hmm. mission yes. and vision that you portrayed was just, that's why we're here to support you, Maya, because we realize that pain is there. 30 something years has passed and we know that pain is there. It doesn't, I can see sometimes it doesn't even make you flow comfortably and happily. We may make jokes on this platform, but this is a serious, sensitive subject. And so, like you were saying, Hana, to have a vision where you empower your communities to protect children against sexual abuse is a clear mission, is a clear vision, I'm sorry, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm glad you didn't cloud it with a bunch of words and a bunch of ideology. It's simple. Empower the community that protect children against sexual abuse, and that's what you're standing up for. And as Hana, as you said in the vision, in the mission, I'm sorry, it's the vision then the mission, to raise that awareness and prevention, you know, and it's why it was so easy for me to want to join you, because gosh, what little can I do to help promote, to help the awareness? And that's what this podcast and over the next so many weeks are going to be about. We're going to talk about it. We're going to unzip our mouth and we're going to say, stop it already. So our listeners, I think some people are empathetic. And with the level of empathy, they understand that that pain is still there, you know. But in the middle of your pain, you were able to release some of the pain with the book, Suffered in Silence, Turned the Pain into Power. With the power you have now, you had some goals you have written in that same brochure. And maybe you can tell us some of the things you've been doing lately and some of the goals you were able to accomplish. I'm so excited about this part.
We've been doing well with the MOP. It wasn't easy because, of course, when I launched the MOP here in the Philippines, we have to start from the scratch. And we have to register it to the Security and Exchange Commission so that we are all legal for the people's work. And you know what? The people's work here in the Philippines is ridiculous. I'm saying that because, you know, it took a lot of time to register it and all this, you know, registration time and all that. So it was, I would say it's ridiculous, you know, time. So for the first year of MOP, 2017, we've launched the MOP in 2017 here in the Philippines. And we have the registration. We registered on Security and Exchange in June 19, 2017. Then, and the time in 2017, we visited, like I think was more than 30 children from the DSWD, Department of Social and Welfare Development in Davao. We visited more than 30 children who are sexually abused or rape victims from the age of 6 or 7 until 17. It was my first time facing children who are sexually abused for the last, more than a decade. It was really heartbreaking, and because it happened to me. And the year after, we visited the children as well in Visayas called a Chameleon Association. There was more than 40 children sexually abused as well, or rape victims from 6 years old to 17 years old. And this organization, this foundation, the founder was the lady from France, Lorraine Luger, and she was amazing. And this, it was 2018, we visited those children. And in 2019, I myself, by myself, visited a foundation in Luzon, a part of Luzon, Olongapo. The foundation called Prida Foundation, which is the founder from Ireland. And his name is Father Shane Collins, I think. So he got this foundation for more than 30 years. And I met the children, more than 30 children as well, rape victims, survivors as well, from 7 years old to 18 years old. And then so far, since then, our foundation are, you know, doing well, and we've been having this community service, which is, you know, giving an information to the community, which is different barangays in Davao City. And yeah, and you know, educate some parents and children as well in the community.
You know, Hana, you're a big supporter of Maya, and you're always there. I saw you there, and you're definitely a person who is a support. How do you view the private and public support of the organization?
The private and public support of the organization?
Yes. Because you're involved enough to kind of get from a inside looking out or outside looking in. I think you get a chance to see, and you yourself are private. So the way you support is amazing. And so we appreciate that. What are you seeing as support, and what more can be done?
I'm personally, as a private supporter, since we're friends, and it's go beyond friends, because it's more than, like, we are somehow educating people, like, to talk. So as a support, I am as a private person, it would be easier for me to go there, because I am flexible. I can offer my time to the organization. While on the other hand, in a public support, like from the government, from the barangay level, it would somehow take time for us to connect with them, because somehow they follow protocols. You need to forward letter, you need to have this meeting, and you have to follow the schedule. And sometimes you also follow our schedule. So I think that what made is it hard is that the unison, you know what I mean? We have this schedule and they have this schedule, but sometimes we don't meet, because the public support really needs, somehow they are also busy, you know? So we have to chase them in a way. We have to really flexible and adjust to them. And we also have our time. I think that's the challenge, having the support or seeking the support from the government or like public support, you know. But from private, we have also, I'm a business person. As a business person, I am flexible, so I can just easily give my time when I am free. But it's more on, I think, kasi it's more on emotional support and mental support, but we need the financial support that is really what we need for MOP to stand. Because somehow, even if it's an organization, it's also a form of business. So that, how can I can differentiate? It's being flexible, and somehow it should be unity, unison with the public or the government support.
Right. So, yeah. Because I saw both there when I visited, and we went through the meetings and the fifth anniversary. And so that's a new word for me, the barangay.
Barangay, yeah.
Yeah, so I was so happy that he prioritized his time to make sure he was there. So he showed that it was important enough for him. And the number of people there from a private supporters, I mean, again, we look forward to having them on in this program as far as interviewing. Even the barangay, it would be nice to have him on one day to talk to us. But when we prioritize In business, we say what gets measured gets managed, and what gets managed gets measured. So being aware of something and prioritizing something makes it more important. One thing you mentioned, and Maya, nothing is conducted for free. The lights have to stay on, the rent has to be paid, mortgage, and so on. And when an organization, even if it's a nonprofit, people don't really understand how nonprofits work. And nonprofits still need resources in order to get things done, even if it's printing a paper or building a building. How can people make donations to your organization? What are the possibilities and the different levels?
Yes, they can donate financially first, of course, because we need a lot of new things in our office. And if they have, if they want to donate whatever they can afford, like if they want to donate cement, it's fine. If you want to donate a bookshelf, a table, or anything that we need from the office before we will start, we will go fly high. Before we will start for a few children, like we've been planning for the next 2 or 3 years for our goal from this year, that as soon as we will have this license from the DSWD, we will have the 2 or 4 children rehoused into the center, the place where you've been the last few weeks ago. Uh-huh. So we will be needing financial support from people, from their heart, so that we can help them, we can give them an intervention. And also, there's a lots of new things to do. Even though there are only 2 or 3 children, we still need to pay a lot of new things for to make them comfortable. Because for now, honestly, there are a lot of children keep messaging us from the age of 9, 14, 16, that they want to go away from their house, from their perpetrator, because their perpetrator are the member of the family. So my heart is bleeding because myself, I spend by my own source. I work as a nanny, private nanny in the UK to support this organization so that it won't die, because I wanted this to go, to move forward. So I, anyone who want to support any kind of anything that they wanted to support or they wanted to donate is more than welcome. And especially financially, so that we can to move forward for this organization.
Yeah, sometimes in my other programs, I speak about giving back, and people miss the idea. Sometimes we know financial resources are needed, but if someone says all I have is a little bit of time, I know you welcome that also.
Yes, of course. And if they have, they have time, because sometimes as well we receive some emails and saying that what can we help for your organization, and I have maybe I can do something to help, or if you have a children, I can offer my knowledge or to talk to these children, and some was also they even offered that if they can do something to raise some funds for the organization, we're more than welcome also.
Yeah, and it's, yeah. So it's quite clear that it's needed. And Hana, as we get closer to what we wanted to cover today, because we know we want to come back on week after week and cover different subjects. What about contact? What is the best way? For your contacts, what is the best way for? I mean, you said you get emails. We can really highlight here those contacts, and I put it also in the podcast description. I think I put some of the contact email and address. But can someone call you just directly?
Yes, they can. They can go to Our website is www.mobinc.org. So they can go through to the website, and we have lots of information there. And also inside in the website, there is a section that planning or, planning for the next 2 or 3 years. There is a section there that how you can donate as well and what you can donate. And at the back of our flyers in the website, you can find as well the bank account is the Philippine National Bank. That's we have the account number, Maya's Organization Philippines INC, and there's a bank account as well. And there's a SWIFT code that they can donate anything they want. And also we have the telephone number they can connect. They can call us as well.
And this will be good if you put a picture of it too up on Instagram or something and keep sharing it with us. We'll keep sharing it. Because this is an opportunity where we tell people to put their money where their mouth is. Because if we want to pull children out of darkness, if we want to make a difference, taking people out of the silence, out of suffering and silence, sometimes we have to give. And when I met you, I said we will do a podcast. This is what I do. And so this is our second week of podcasting and talking about this subject. And so it's a way of spending my time and energy and resource in order to get it done. And so these are examples of what we find to be important, you know, not just talk, but just take action and actually do something. So I know one day I'll be back there and get involved in doing more things to help build your organization up, not for the purpose of building an organization up, but taking an effort towards reducing anyone, especially children, suffering in silence, and that we can turn some of that pain into power by supporting this organization, no doubt.
Right, yeah.
So, no, this is great. And the reason why we covered this week's No Child Should Suffer in Silence and Cry in Darkness, and any human could say no one should, we're focusing on no child should, and that's important. So we covered some of the mission, the vision, some of the goals, the programs that you have going on where people can get help and assistance and supported. And like you mentioned, sometimes people call and say they want to remove themselves because it's a family member who are the perpetrators. And so, gosh, the organization needs a safe zone for them. So if there's a place they can go, they can have a safe zone. One of your goals was to create a safe zone, wasn't it? I think you told me it was a building or a center you're working on.
Yes, that was the biggest goal that we are planning ahead for the next, I don't know, maybe 5 or 10 years or 15 years. I don't know when, whenever the financial would be. The biggest goal we have is the rehabilitation center that the children can cater children for more than 30 to 50 or 100 children across the country. So I don't know if that, I don't know when it's going to be happening, but that's my vision. That's the MOP's mission, that we can cater these children across the country, not only in Davao, the Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So
it's really good because you've accomplished quite a few goals over the last 5 years, and it's definitely an important goal, and let our listeners and donate people who donate and support you to know that you have bigger goals and that to put something together, something that you did not have when you were a child, and your goal will be to have something and somewhere to go as a child. And so that is very ambitious and very well needed, and everyone should support that goal. And so I appreciate that. So yeah, we will keep talking about where you can be contacted and where donations can go to, and we'll keep talking about your goals. Over the next few weeks, we will go into your book and talk about each of the different chapters of your book. Next week, we'll talk about your childhood, and we're using it as an angle to listen to hear about Hana's childhood and to talk about the concept of childhood, why it shouldn't be ruined. So yeah. Although the book just says childhood, and the following week we said, like, you know, where you've worked in other countries and other cultures, we can tie all of those messages in as we continue week after week talking about this very subject, suffered in silence, turned the pain into power. So I really appreciate you guys being on.
Yeah.
And I know I think we switch locations at time. Right now you're in the Philippines. I think you're in the Cebu area. Maya?
No, I'm in Manila.
Oh, you're in Manila. And Manila. Hana, you're still...
And I'm still in Davao.
Okay. And myself, yeah, in
I'm
Houston.
I'm still in Davao.
I think next week you said you might be in London. And we, as we continue this conversation, we will keep our mouths unzipped in this case. We will not be silenced in this case.
Yeah.
And we'll continue to have this conversation about suffering in silence. And we're going to turn the pain into power right here on Free Talk with Mr. B. So thank you so much for this conversation. I look forward again to talking. Look forward again to talking next week about childhood from the book that we're talking about, Suffered in Silence. And it's in chapter one. We'll go over that conversation. Yes?
That's great. Thank you.
Thank you. And we really appreciate you guys for being on.
Looking forward for that.
Yes, we appreciate our listeners. And we will keep sharing information and share contact information and how to donate information, knowing all too well what the goals are, what the mission is, and what the vision about this organization, MOP. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having
us. Thank you so much.
Yeah, all right, good evening, and you guys have a good evening.
See you next week. Good evening.
Right.
See you next week.